Welcome back to Reading Bear. Today, we will take a look at some new I Don't Work Here Lady stories. And if you enjoyed my content, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and post some bear emojis in the comments. Let's go!
The first story is titled Careful I'm Armed. This happened about 1 year ago. Now all the dust is settled, I can spit it all out. Me is me, W is wife, S is son. Karen is Karen. About a year or so ago, I and my wife purchased a third home for rental income. I am 6'4", male of Moroccan, Middle Eastern descent. I'm commonly mistaken for Latino or light-skinned African American. This will be an important fact later on. So we were at a Lowe's in Pacoima. To my delight, there was a darker Moroccan kid working behind the paint counter. Very helpful, nice, respectful kid, maybe in his early 20s. So the family swing by Lowe's to pick up some stuff to start on the new house. My wife was picking out tile with my son. I was talking to the kid behind the paint counter. An older Armenian man came up and asked the kid to get something down. The kid had a line of people, so I told him, "Don't worry, I'm tall enough, I'll grab it." The guy was very grateful. I walked back to the counter to pick up my order. I began loading it on my cart and boom. There it stood in all its glory, a wild Karen. Taken in on the kid who said nothing. And it goes like this, me. Lady, the line's in the front but pickup's here. Karen. Oh great, another one of you people work here, okay, I need you to take this to my car. Me. Hey kiddo, happy Ramadan and I'll see you at service. I turn and this sharp pain twinges my shoulder. Me. Lady, watch yourself, don't do that again. You won't like the outcome. Karen. Listen here, Wan, load my crap or I'll get your manager. Dot now, lazy border jumpers. Ugh, I hate these people. Me. Really, watch yourself, lady, I don't work here and you just committed simple assault. Karen. Okay, I'm sick of you wetbacks, I'm going to get the manager. Me. You do that, princess. By the time my wife and kid came and I was loading up the second flatbed. After getting some brushed and rollers, we headed to the cashier. Karen, there he is, he was the OE that shoved me, I want him arrested. The store manager turned white. I had given him a speeding ticket and cut him a breaker the day before because he was late. Karen. Call the cops now, I want him fired and arrested for assault. Store manager. I can't do that. He look at me and I'm so SRRYLT. Karen the realized she had made a mistake. To cover myself, I called my chief and he sent a car out. Karen, you what this lazy Mexican a hole won't help me and you say SRRY to him. In walk another LT and a detective. They both say hi, ask me if I'm armed and I said yeah. They ask me if I'm okay, I say yeah. They look at Karen then asked for the security tape. Everyone is pulled off the store floor and Karen has no idea what's about to happen. I'm not a normal cop. I live in the neighborhood I grew up in, I own property in the neighborhood I grew up in. I treat everyone with respect. I serve my community, always have. This lady WASNT from my community. As we are sitting in the manager's office. The office girl says hi to my wife. Said hi to me and told me thanks for helping her dad. Karen screams there, I thought you worked here. I stayed quiet, another kid I actually dropped him off at Lowe's because his car broke down came in and asked, LT you okay? I said yeah of course. Karen was promptly handcuffed and walked out to the car. She the yelled out that I had a gun. The det said, he is supposed to, he is a cop. I got on duty the next evening, I was called to talk to a detective. They wanted to know if I provoked the attack. Did I draw my weapon at any time? I of course said no. I told them to finish interviews at the store. To take a look at the camera footage. They already had, but Karen stated I drew my weapon and egged her on. They has to ask the question. Welp, Karen got 3 months for assault and 3 years probation, if could have been worse. She could have pulled that on a gang member around there. Who still have more respect than Karen. Be good to each other guys, and know your rights. If you are in doubt of anything on a stop with law enforcement, ask for a supervisor. BLM and all lives matter, I'm a human being and a devout Muslim before I'm a cop. The next story is titled, I was not robbed for not working there. The story begins a couple of years ago. I was in a supermarket, more specifically in an OXXO. I don't know if in any other country there is an OXXO in a buying chips and soda, when I see a strange guy who approached me and asked me a couple of things. I told him that he didn't work there but he would gladly help him. I helped him find a couple of things, he thanked me and he left. I took my things and being in the box I see the guy again and I hear him scream, "This is a robbery, all hands up." At that moment I was very scared. At that moment the guy sees me and tells me, "You can go, friend, thanks for the help," and without thinking I left the place running as fast as I could in my entire life. I did not know what happened next. I just know that I am very grateful for not having to pay for my snacks XD. I know maybe this story is not going here, but I will try it. I hope everyone has a good day. The next story is titled, "Wiper. Google can help you." So I needed a headlight bulb for my car and I went to generic chain auto parts store after work. My work uniform is a generic red polo and tan tack pants, black boots. The same as the auto parts store. I also had my earbuds in for music. Since I have a medical condition, I usually have my service dog with me, but it was a quick trip so I figured I'd be okay without him and using music to help me. I go to the headlight section and I'm googling what kind of bulb my car needs. Enter Karen, "Excuse me. I think she just needs me out of her way to get whatever she needs or to pass," so I back up and move a few steps away from her. "Excuse me." This time I think she's wanting to pass me, but social distancing is a thing, so I decide to take a lap around the aisle. "Excuse me." It's louder this time, maybe I'm not walking fast enough, so I speed up. She grabs my shoulder. I don't particularly care for being touched ever, and certainly not by strangers in a store. I duck, dodge, pulling away from her, then stare appalled. "Kay, I need you to help me find a wiper. Me, I don't work here, but they're right here. Kay, I drive a 2017 Honda. Me, I don't work here. Kay, just because you took your name tag off doesn't mean you don't work here. So I have a Honda Pilot, I need wiper." I start to just walk away, Karen grabs my arm. "Kay, I'm talking to you. You can't just walk away. Me, lady, I don't work here. The front can help you, Google can help you. I cannot. Kay, you obviously work here. You're wearing the uniform." I try to just walk away again, and she grabs my arm, so I start screaming. This got the attention of someone who actually works there. "Worker, what's going on?" "Me, I'm being assaulted by this woman because I don't work here and I can't help her." "Kay, you work here. You're wearing the uniform, you're being incredibly rude. You need to help me." "Me, I'm calling the cops, you assaulted me, this place has video cameras and you continued to assault me." At this point the manager walks over, Karen continued to yell at him about how I definitely work there and how rude and unprofessional I am. I reiterated that I don't work here. Karen yelled more and I just walked away, leaving the manager to calm down the Karen. I got my headlight and left. No, I didn't end up calling the police, but I would have had no issues doing so. I chose to get home to calm down and since I can now laugh about this, so can you. The next story is titled, "My Dad, the Perpetually Mistaken for Employee." I don't recall ever personally being mistaken for a store employee, but I have been a part of so many, "I don't work here, lady," stories that I've lost count years ago. And that's because my dad has successfully pulled off the old nerdy guy so well that is constantly being mistaken for a store employee of some kind. I used to witness this all the time as a kid when going to the store with my dad. My dad would don his usually plaid button-down shirt, very non-trendy and ill-fitting jeans, and loafers. There were no smartphones back then, so he would literally go around with a folded-up piece of paper and at least two pens in his breast pocket, sticking out of course for all to see. His look was completed with large glasses and a truly terrible comb over, which would frequently be mistaken for a bad toupee. I truly love the guy, but his look is almost a caricature. So this is what would happen: we would go to a place like Home Depot or Best Buy or some computer store and my dad would pull out his folded paper and pen and start going up and down the aisle taking meticulous notes about whatever product he was shopping for. It could be computer hard drives, but it could also be light bulbs. It's just what he did. I, of course, would wander a little away, occupy myself. But on the regular, he would always get mistaken for store employees, even though he never had the signature uniform that those types of stores would give their employees. Some unsuspecting customer would wander over and say, "Excuse me, but can you tell me where can I find XYZ? Dad, no. Customer, no. What do you mean, no? Dad, well, why should I? Customer. Dad, returns to jotting down notes. Customer, don't you work here? Dad, no. Customer, ok. Incredulous look, not sure what to believe. Reality shattered. The next story is titled, Lady Thinks I Work at Walgreens. Now, this is extremely short, but it's my only IDWHL encounter thus far. So a few months ago my mother had some emergency surgery. After being released from the hospital, and was recovering a home, I had to go pick up her prescription order, do some shopping, and pick up her ready prescriptions. So I hop in my 15-year-old Suburban, and head to Walgreens. It should be mentioned that the state I live in is progressively about a decade behind others, and this happened before COVID. So I park, grab my backpack and wallet, and hop out of the car. Now, I'm about 5'2", and under 21. My little backpack is basically my purse, as it's a lot easier to carry my emergency meds and books in. I'm dressed in a Rolling Stones t-shirt, denim shorts, knee-high compression socks, and running shoes. Suffice to say, not dressed like Walgreens employees. I walk in the door and head straight back to the pharmacy, tiny illegible hospital note in hand. I wait in line, drop off the note, and head out. It'd be at least a 20-minute wait, so I decided to do my shopping. Getting all the groceries goes smoothly, and I head back to Walgreens. I walk in and instead of going straight to pharmacy, I go to the soft drinks aisle to get my death drink of choice. I have a heart condition, to explain my emergency meds, and decided I wanted a Monster. I bought my drink and started heading to the back. Some middle-aged lady, could have MAAAAYBE been late 60s, came up to me with two gift cards in hand. She's mumbling something unintelligible about buying them, and pushing them towards my face. One card was for a high-end restaurant, and the other was an alcohol shop. I looked at her, very confused and just said, "I haven't the slightest," then stood silent. We both stood there staring at each other as she was trying to input the news. She then walked past me, and I started to the pharmacy. I'm guessing she did a double take because she stopped me and apologized, saying she thought I worked there. I said it was all right, and went to pick up my mum's medication. Still don't know how she thought I worked there. My bag was a tiny drawstring and clip American Stripes backpack. I had no name tags, and was quite visible a sick child. I say sick in regards to my conditions. The next story is titled, The Wonderful Elderly Man. Wholesome story time. It may not fully fit here, but it was so amazing. This past weekend my family visited Williamsburg, VA to chill and relax at a resort. It was quite wonderful and it was nice being away from home. One day we stopped by the Lennox store, porcelain store that sells plates, cutlery, some decorations, and collectibles. This was our second trip to the store that day since Mum wanted to double check the price of something we bought. I bought a Disney collectible on the first trip and figured out how the sale worked. The store is closing, so some of the inside sale signage doesn't explain how the sale fully works. So, I'm heading back to the Disney collectibles again and this elderly couple are at the display case for the Disney stuff and are trying to figure out how this sale works. So I decide to casually tell this wonderful man and his wife how the sale works as I happen to be near and just being kind. I work retail, so I guess my customer service side came out. After he and his wife thanked me, he asked if I worked there and I say no. He can't believe it and yells over to the people who do work at this store that they need to hire me for $85 an hour. It was such a compliment. After that I buy a second Disney collectible and leave. That little interaction made my day. The next story is titled, Just the Random Encounter. I was out shopping because I had to pick up some rain gear. My boss informed me that I would be working outside the day before. I work construction, and the forecast was pouring rain, so I go to a store with a big red farm vehicle as its logo. Unfortunately, I am a very short, skinny person, and I already knew finding gear that fit me well was going to be tough, so I'm trying a jacket on to see if it was small enough. Naturally, way too big, so I hang it back up. Up walks this guy. Mind you, I'm wearing a bell cap that has my company name on it, a neon yellow shirt with my company name, dirty blue jeans, and dusty work boots. The store uniform is a red shirt with store name and black slacks, jeans. He waits for me to finish hanging the jacket up and I pull my phone out to call the next store to see if they had anything small. He clears his throat and I scoot out of the way, assuming I was in his way. "Excuse me, miss, can you tell me how much these boots are?" I look up at this guy, standing right beside me, fortunately with a mask. My area has mandated them again, but the store I was in wasn't actively requiring them, but not social distancing. "I'm sorry, I don't work here," I replied. "Oh. I just assumed you did 'cause you're young and were stocking the shelf." "No, I need something like that, but that's much too big. I need smaller, but that's the smallest they have. And I appreciate the compliment on my age. I've got two kids and I'm almost 30. The last sentence was an epic lie, but I could see it made him feel better about bothering me. I did find rain gear at another store, still much too big, but slightly better suited to my size, so it does what it's supposed to. The next story is titled, "Karen Argues and Slapped Me Because I Told Her I Didn't Work There." You probably will think this is fake, but here's the story. Basically, I used to work at a fast food employee. My outfit was really different from the ones in Target, the place I was going to. After my 8-hour shift, I got groceries from Target and I was just getting some stuff and then Karen arrives. She didn't have the haircut, but she had the attitude. Karen was asking me where the clothing was. I said I didn't know and then we had an argument. "Okay, how are you working here if you have the memory of a goldfish and you can't even remember where items are in?" "M, I don't work here. I don't even have the uniform and a name tag." "K, you're lying. You're being racist to me. Why do you have to make my life more worse by discriminating me? I'm going to get you fired." "M, go ahead. They probably won't believe you because 1. You act like a raging bull, and 2. The only thing you say is bullcrap." Karen then slaps me and screams assault. An employee with a manager is now there. "MA, what the hell happened here?" "E, I heard what happened. This woman slapped this gentleman and screamed assault." "K, lies. He is obviously taking his side because he works here and just wants to help him not get fired." "MA, ma'am, she doesn't work here. Our uniforms are different. I will check the security cameras and if employee isn't lying, we would call the cops." Karen is now pale as a ghost. She is trembling and even tried to get out of the store, but employees stopped her. I obviously pressed charges. The cops were called and Karen was arrested for assault. She also tried to resist arrest because she tried running outside, but her attempt only made her slip and gets a bruise. The next story is titled, "Short and Sweet Story That Just Happened." I'm at the OMAX buying an office chair this afternoon. I've paid, I'm holding my receipt waiting for the good fellow who rang me up to roll up my purchase. That fellow is wearing red. The guy at the next register is wearing red. The employees wear red. I'm wearing khakis and a dark gray polo. Casual Friday in this idiot. And of course we're masked up, right? So a random guy walks up to me and asks if I sell stamps. I'm in recruiting and professional development, so I say, "No, I sell people." The look he gave was priceless. Ha. He's thinking I'm in some trafficking ring at this point, I don't know. I sell people to IT firms. It clicks. He was chill. Apologizes, hangs his head, and shuffles off to someone wearing a name tag. Not as glorious as other stories, but it was fun and I have no friends to talk to. Cheers and have a good weekend. The next story is titled, "Treat Me Like a Child." I'll treat you like a child. So on to the backstory. The town I lived in wasn't huge and at the time only had one gas station. I got a job there at the ripe old age of 15 and worked there for 2 years. By the end of my time there I was essentially number 3, with the manager and ass manager ahead, in charge. Eventually another gas station opened up across the road and I got a job there. There was pretty high turnover, so by the end of my tenure there everybody else including the managers were new. This story takes place about a year after I left them. One last thing to say, puberty is an idiot and didn't feel like making its way over to me forever, so from age 12 to 18 I looked like the same. Not exactly, but I looked really young until about 19, a little bit insecure about it. So, since I knew all the employees at the store I would always get gas and grab a nice ice cold chocolate milk from there rather than my store. When I got to the fridge with my milk I was dismayed to find that there was no more. But seeing as I spent the entirety of my working time at the same store, I knew that they kept the stock in the back of the walk-in fridge behind some boxes. This fridge was also where all the beer was, so when a customer, old idiot, noticed that I knew what I was doing, assumed I worked there. That seems fair considering she had probably seen me there on many occasions, and I usually have no problem helping people. Oh, if I had known that how good a day this would turn out to be. Ob, hey kid. Knowing that there wasn't anybody else in this tight-ass fridge, I turned around from fumbling about in the boxes. Ob, Yayu, go put this case of beer at the cash, holding out case of beer. Even if I did work there, I wouldn't have done it, but I figured I'd gently remind them I am an actual person. Me, sorry, I don't work here anymore. Plus, miss, that was really rude. I'm going to have to assume that I triggered something for her because she lost her crap screaming about how she had seen me here before and she knew I worked here. I tried to get a word in edgewise but was unable to, and with her between the door and myself, I figured I might as well try and ignore her and find my chocolatey goodness. Ob, look at me when I'm talking to you. You ungrateful child. Me, look, it seems like you're having a bad day, so I'm going to let all that slide and just remind you that I no longer work here. With a huff, she turned around and walked out, but not before she threw out one last insult. Ob, your mother must have been incompetent to have raised such a selfish boy. I had been having a good day up until that point because my usual self is a vindictive little crap who normally would have screamed right back at her. That changed when she insulted my mother. I found my drink and went to the registers. These machines were ancient and took about 15 minutes to boot up and glitches frequently. Karma strikes quick and without mercy, for when I got to the cash they were having some technical problem with it and the screen was frozen, glitched, karma. Knowing there was nobody in the store except for myself, the idiot and my buddy who just started working there about 3 months prior, I was in no rush to help. When my friend finally got fed up with trying the usual debug procedure, he looked up and asked for my help. When working there, I was the go-to person and I still frequently got calls from the management asking if I could pop by and fix something for them in exchange for some free candy. Win-win. I glanced over at the screen and immediately recognized the problem and knew that it was a simple fix. All he had to do was click two buttons at the same time. If you had thought that Ob had gotten in quieter as this whole process was going on, you were wrong. She must have seen the recognition in my face when I saw it, because she started howling at me to fix it so she could get out of there. Seeing my chance for revenge, I struck. Me, apologize. Ob, stunned look, what did you say to me? Me, I would like you to apologize to me and I'll fix the problem. Ob, you little crap, fix it right now or I'll have you fired. Me, I'd like to remind you that I don't work here and I still expect an apology. I assume she was running late because after another 2 to 3 minutes of back and forth she finally relented. Ob, grumble, I'm sorry. Now will you fix the machine? And normally I would have accepted it, but I still had another 30 minutes to get killed before I started work at the gas station across the road, so I figured I'd push it. Me, sorry for what? More incoherent yelling from this lady and my friend tries to stifle his laughter. Me, I didn't hear an apology in there. Ob, I'm sorry. For being rude, even though you were being a brat. I stared at her, just thinking, she was so close, so close, she could have been free to enjoy her beer and free to annoy anybody else that crossed her path. But alas, it was not meant to be. Me, nah. I don't accept, have a nice day. She had a dumb look on her face before it turned to a scowl and she started screaming again. Ob, I swear I'm never coming back to this gas station ever again. The employees here are expletive. As she stormed out. Now most people would be content with that, I however was not. I quickly hit the buttons fixing the machine and ran out yelling a quick goodbye and telling him I'm pay for this tomorrow. See, she swore the one thing I knew she wouldn't be able to keep, she swore she was never coming back to that gas station. Which could only mean she had one place to go for her booze. Across the road, to the gas station I work at, the place where I'm the number one employee and where the owner would back me up if he were there, and if he wasn't I was in charge. I ran over to my job and told the cashier to him to take a break, sit back, and enjoy the show. By the time I got there she had already rushed into the fridge to get her beer, and when she got out she was greeted by the sight of me grinning from ear to ear behind the register. Cut to 15 minutes of swearing later and she leaves again, sans beer. My co-worker standing there slack-jawed wondering how I was able to stand that verbal tirade, and even more confused as to why I kept on laughing even more as she went on. That was a good day. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe to the channel and post some bear emojis in the comment.